There's an ayah in the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah verse 132. Surah Al-Baqarah verse 132, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to us about Ya'qub, Prophet Jacob, Ya'qub, the father of Yusuf. When he was on his deathbed, what does he say to his children? He says, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ. This is what Ibrahim said to his children, and this is what Ya'qub said to his children. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ. Allah chose you to be the standard bearers, to be the ones who carry His religion. فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Ibrahim and Ya'qub, they say what? Do not die unless you are Muslim. Meaning, hold on to your aqidah when you are experiencing death. It's not easy. In Surah Al-Mu'minun, Surah 23, verses 97 and 98, there is a dua that's mentioned that we should all become familiar with. وَقُلْ رَبِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ هَمَزَاتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from the whispering of the Satans. وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ رَبِّي أَنْ يَحْضُرُونَ. And I seek refuge with you, oh Allah, from their presence. What is this ayah talking about? It's talking about the waswasa and the presence of shayateen when you're dying. Because shaytan is not going to leave you. Shaytan wants to shake you up before you die, so you die without faith. This is why people used to come to Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam. They used to say to the Imam, a man by the name of Muhammad ibn Salman al-Daylami, one of the companions of Imam al-Sadiq, he says, "Inna shi'atakum yaqul إن الإيمان قسمان أحدهما مستقر وثابت والآخر مستودع ويزول." He tells the Imam that your Shias, your followers, say that there are two types of faith. There's two types of Iman. There is faith that is firm, it's deep rooted, and there is faith that is shaky and depart. What does this mean? The Imam says it means there are some people, when they're dying, they panic and they start having doubts and they relinquish their belief. It departs them when they encounter death, and there are those who remain firm. So then he asks the Imam, فَعَلِّمْنِي دُعَاءً إِذَا قَرَأْتُهُ كَمُلَ إِيمَانِي وَاسْتَقَرُ. Oh Imam, teach me something that if I do it, it will secure my faith. Because brothers and sisters, if your aqidah, if your beliefs are shaky when you're alive, what's going to happen to you when you're on your deathbed? Some of us, our aqidah is weak when we're alive. You need to know what you believe and why you believe it. So he says to the Imam, teach me a dua that will secure my faith and it will prevent it from departing me in my last moments. The Imam says, قُلْ بَعْدَ كُلِّ فَرِيضًا. After every prayer, after your daily prayers, after you finish, sit on your musalla. Don't just grab your phone right away. Read the following dua. رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبًّا وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ نَبِيًّا. I am pleased with God as my Lord and with Muhammad as my Prophet. وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا. And I am pleased with Islam as my faith. وَبِالْقُرْآنِ كِتَابًا. And that the Quran is my book and the Kaaba is my qibla. وَبِعَلِيٍ وَلِيًّا وَإِمَامًا. And you mentioned the imams. اللَّهُمَّ إِنِّي رَضِيتُ بِهِمْ أَئِمَّةً. If you do this, if you dictate to your soul your creed, you will secure it on the day that you pass away. It won't depart.